Now we are ready with the slider. Next we need to get the details of the product when the slider values changes. That is when the handle is moved or the slider value is changed, and also when the page is loaded, we need to get the details of the products within that particular range. So let us try to write a function called getDetails and call this function as we want. So let me name it as getDetails. And I want to have the minimum and maximum values, that is the price range, so that we can do the calculations. So minimum comma maximum, and within this what we first need to do, when the values are changed or when the page is loaded, we should get the price range here, right? So how we can get it? We can display it within this span element with ID range. So here we need to specify $#range.text, how it should be. So here we can specify dollar, then the minimum value. So minimum, then we can have a space, then the hyphen, again a space, okay. Then we can display, then here itself we can write dollar, then the maximum value. Hope you understand this, because in the price range we are actually displaying which is the currently selected price or the minimum and maximum values. So when we call this function on the page load and also on the slider change event, we are passing the minimum and maximum, and that values are being displayed in this span element. Next, we need to get the details within the specified price range, and we should display it as a table. You can display it as you want here. For easy understanding and seeing the output clearly, we are making it as a table. So first we need to have the table structure, right? So let me write var result equals, let me first open the table tag, okay? Then let me add a row, and these are the headings. So I can add th, and within this, sorry, th, and within this we need to specify the product name, that is a heading. So product name, then I have to close this th, so th, then again one more heading, that is the price in dollars, so again one more th, the title is price, and in bracket I can specify in dollar, okay, and then I need to close the th and also the tr, that is the table row. Hope you understand this. We are actually going to display the result within a table. So we need to have the starting of the table, and we will add each item within the specified range as each row within the table. Okay, here it should be closed. Okay, now the structure is ready. Next, what we need to do, we actually need to loop through this JavaScript object to check whether any item is there within this minimum and maximum range. So to loop through an object, we can use for in loop. Okay. So for var item in details, we can specify this name as you want, for var x or y or whatever it is. I am specifying var item in details. What should we check? If details of item, that is the price. Item will be the key and details of item will be the corresponding value. Okay. So if details of item is greater than or equal to minimum and details of item is less than or equal to maximum, that is the amount is within this range, then what should we do? We need to display the product name and the corresponding value, that is the price. So how we can do that? Here we can specify result plus equals, that is we are going to add the values as a row. So here we need to add a tr, then as the first cell td, we need to add the item as the value in this cell. So item, then we need to close the td, and again one more td, and within this, what we should display, it should be the amount. So we can get it using details of item. Hope you understand this. It is a bit difficult to understand. Actually, we are creating a table with the products within the range and its corresponding values. So for in loop is used to loop through an object, JavaScript object. So its structure is like this: for where the name of the variable in the name of the JavaScript object. So item will be the key and details of item will be the value. If the name we are specifying here is X, then X will be the key and details of X, that is the name of the object of X, will be the corresponding value. Okay, this is basic JavaScript. It has nothing to do with jQuery UI. Now we are adding each row. So within TR, we have to add TD, which is the cell. So first we need to have the item, then details of item. Then what should we do? We need to close the TD and also the TR. So it will create a row, right? So once we loop through the entire JavaScript object, by the end of this loop, all the items will be added as different rows in this result variable. So after this for loop, what should we do? We need to close the table, right? So it is now in the opened state. We need to close it. So after the for loop, let me specify result plus equals, what is it? It should be closing of table. Okay. And we can display this result within this output div element. So we can specify dollar hash result. Sorry, it is not result, it is output. So output dot html, it is in the result variable. So it is a HTML structure of the table. Now let us try to see the output, whether we are getting it or not. Let me refresh. Okay, we haven't called this function, right? We have just written the function. We haven't called it. So where should we call it? We actually have to call it once the page is loaded. So how we can call it? We need to get the minimum and maximum. So how we can get the minimum and maximum values? From this values option, we can get it, right? So let me create a variable called current and let me specify dollar hash slider, that is the ID dot slider. It is a method. What value we need? We need to get the value of the option values. So it will be an array, right? So values, then we can call the function get details with current of 0, which will be the minimum, and it will be 15. We can actually hard code if we want. I don't want to do hard coding. So here I'm doing like this, and current of 1 will give us the maximum value. Now let us check whether we are getting the output or not. Let me refresh. Okay, we are not getting the output. Let us check the code. Okay, here this also should be put in double quotes. That is the name of the option should be set in double quotes. I think that is the error. Let me save this. Let me refresh. Okay, this part is done, but we are not able to see the table. That is, we are seeing the price range which we have written inside this function. Okay, hash range dot text minimum and maximum, that is being displayed here. I think we can display this in bold. So what we can do, we can actually style this span element with ID range for displaying it in bold. So after this, let me add the style tag. Anyhow, we need to do some styling. So first let us style the range span element and let me specify font weight to be bold. Okay, you can increase the font size if you want. Let me refresh. Okay, it is also displayed in bold. Now the issue is we are not able to see the output in table, right? So let us check the code here. It is table trth. Here also it is correct. Let me try to alert inside to check whether the loop is running or not. Let me save this. Let me refresh. Okay, it is not getting displayed. Let me check the code. Details. Okay. This details is actually within this dollar document.ready. Actually, it should be declared as a global variable, then only this function which is outside this document.ready will be able to access it. Okay, I think that is the issue. Let me paste it here and try. Let me save this. Let me refresh. See, it is being displayed. Actually, it is not styled. That is why it is displayed like this. We can style this table a bit and also the slider if we want. Okay, but before that, what we need to do, when the value of the slider is changed, this table should be updated, right? So we need to write the code here. For the change, we need to write the code. So change, we need to call the function, and for this function we will have two parameters. They are event and UI. And it is not to be written here. The parameters are here and we need to write our code here. So what should we do here? We actually need to call this get details with the updated range values. So let me copy this, paste it here. And how we can get the range values, that is the sliders minimum and maximum values, we can get it using UI. If you remember the range slider we have already discussed, we can get it like UI.values(0, UI.values)1. This will give us the current values, that is the changed values of the slider. So let us check it. Let me refresh. It is showing 19, 24 and 29. Let me move this slider towards the left hand side. See, the range is now 9 and 30. So it is showing 10, 14, 19, 24 and 29. Let me increase this. It is still showing the same. 37 is the upper range and 9 is the lower range. And now it is showing USB hub, which is having the value 36. So that part is also working.